what we're looking at here is damage per hit, and of course the comparative data between the different guns within the given time period, whatever that is. So I suppose it doesn't matter.
Did we have to go the extra mile?
Yes, because they didn't listen. This is gonna work.
I'm taking a break. By everyone is they've ruined it, blah. So we decided to do the opposite of a knee-jerk reaction, which is a slow leg movement. Anyway, I'm going to do a bit of a road trip with this car to try and understand it. I'm starting here in the north of Italy, the Italian lakes, and I'm going to drive this thing all the way to the south of France, where I'm going to meet James to test a certain Aston Martin. And then I'm going to drive all the way back into Italy to test a certain Ferrari. It's going to be miserable, but we do it for you. I felt that I used my week before James arrived in Europe wisely. I spent some quality time moseying around northern Italy and experienced not only the sights and sounds, but also the culture. I even had some time for some quiet reflection. I don't like sand. It's cold, rough, irritating, and it gets everywhere. But I put my disdain for sand aside, and I ventured south towards the French Riviera to meet James. And I started to get the hang of the C-63, even if I didn't fully understand it yet.
Because if you missed the memo, the new C63, a vehicle that has had a V8 under the hood for well over a decade, now has a four-cylinder hybrid. Yes, we hear your booms, because we added that sound effect in post. But I say to you, it is at least a rather potent one. With the help of its hybrid system, it puts out a whopping 671 horsepower. And 752 pound-feet of torque, making it the most powerful production four-cylinder in the world. The sexiness of those numbers is more than a little threatened by this compact sedan's 4,600 pound curb weight, about the same as a V8 F-150 Super Crew, or in car terms, it's within 100 pounds of a new full-sized S-Class. But Mercedes claims a 3.3-second 0-60 time, which is not too shabby. And not too shabby is the least we should expect for the almost six-figure estimated price the AMG C63 E-Performance commands. And if you're new to Throttle House, we do car reviews, track tests, and quite a lot of messing about. So subscribe, hit the bell.
As I sped down the Italian autostrada and the miles whisked by, I developed a few issues with the C63. But because of the fact that the highway speeds in Italy seemed to be about a million, before I had a chance to draw any final conclusions, I found myself in Monaco, where I met up with James. At After a day or so with another AMG engined car, we hopped in the C63 and headed back into the heart of continental Europe. Over the next few days, we each spent time in the driver's seat in every different type of driving that Italy, Switzerland, and France had to offer. Highway tolls, traffic jams, tight roads, endless tunnels, famous doorways, you name it. And eventually, we decided to find a bit of a back road to push the C63 even more. And more importantly, to find out if everyone's opinion that it's been ruined is correct. Okay, a back road and a chance to experience the AMG C63 SE 4MATIC plus all-wheel drive. Did I get everything?
Is that the thing is, that when you say AMG, it does... We've had a lot of time on the highway in this car.
Yeah.
And it pulls.
It's quick.
Yeah, I mean, 671 horsepower is
real quick.
Nothing to sniff at.
If I flip this over into race mode, it uses... Oh, I got a corner here. That's happened already.
See, this is where it actually excels.
Yeah, flat, smooth roads. Foot down. That's quick. That is very quick.
Absolutely RS5 and pretty quick.
Oh, no question. All right, watch, actually, if I pull over and I do a launch, I can click this boost button here. Boost. Race start.
So that's in race mode, right? So there's a different mode.
That's in race mode. There's sport plus mode. And all of these modes, as you'd expect, use the battery differently.
Right, they give you a certain amount of it.
Yes.
And it increases, obviously, as you get towards race mode.
Right.
And they stiffen the dampers.
And yes, and the steering and all of that stuff. But then if you are in any mode, and you push your foot down all the way and click the pedal, it gives you full boost.
Yeah, it's a bit lag.
So much turbo lag, yeah. The transmission is good when you're flat out, and it makes like a on the upshift, which I do like.
I have to be honest. Okay, so the big,
hello, hello, hello.
The small elephant in the room is the four cylinder.